Blah, or whatever.
Hey Dino fans, and hopefully Dragon fans, because in today's video, we're going to take a look at some new merchandise for the How to Train Your Dragon Hidden World movie that comes out in about a week. This is almost the video that didn't happen, and that's... I don't want to say it's the fault of DreamWorks in any way, because I like DreamWorks pictures. I've been enjoying them since they started making them, basically. But I'm a Universal Annual Pass holder, and the social media team... The treatment from the social media team towards its UOAPs has gotten kind of lazy and worse over the last couple years. We had an excellent manager for that group, and he moved on to a different company, and ever since then... you know, like, we used to get freebies and special events, and just, it was a better place to be, to hang out. People wouldn't rag on each other and pick on each other and bully each other, and the community's just sort of gotten worse and worse. Well, they do have a screening for How to Train Your Dragon. It takes place tomorrow night, but, they said they were going to release the password for the Eventbrite event at 8 p.m. on the forum. And 8 p.m. came and went, and tickets came and went. They never released the password, but another member of the group hacked the password and gave it out to everyone, and so the tickets were gone. And not everyone had the password, so not everyone had an equal opportunity to get tickets. I understand they don't have to do anything for their pass holders other than give them admission to the park. It's nice to have free parking at some pass levels and some discounts at restaurants and shopping and stuff like that. But if they tell you they're going to do something, in my humble opinion, I think that they should have done it. They should have released the password when they said they were going to, so that everyone would have had an equal chance to miss out on the tickets. And when I complained, I was told, "Sorry, you don't like our sign-up process. We'll forward your feedback." So, I don't know, it's just sort of a culmination of lots of different things with Universal Orlando Resort. They've been very good to me, I've had a good time, I've enjoyed some things, but the social media team has just gotten worse and worse in their treatment of the Universal Annual Pass holders, and I don't think that they are representing DreamWorks properties as well as they could be. Another example is that out in Hollywood, they have... an actual, like, puppeteered Toothless that you can meet. And in Orlando, you get your picture in front of a green screen and they Photoshop Toothless in. I get that they're testing things. I get that they're trying to save money for the fourth gate. But if you chintz and treat people like garbage before the fourth gate even opens, it's going to hurt your business, it's going to hurt your bottom line in the long run, and it's going to make people mad. Like me. Like, I'm an annual pass holder, and I'm pretty much considering not being an annual pass holder anymore because I can't get access to any of the events. It's very difficult to get a hold of the annual pass holder pins that they've been passing out because they run out, like, in the first week of the month, even though they're supposed to have it all month long. They don't scan the passes, so they run out of these things. And people sell them on eBay, and you can't get one, even though it's supposed to be something you're supposed to get for free from Universal. So, I don't know. It just sort of soured my whole opinion of Universal, but I didn't want to hold that against DreamWorks, and I didn't want to hold that against How to Train Your Dragon, because that's an excellent franchise, and I've enjoyed it so far. And I did spend all this money on these toys that you see here in the picture, so I wanted to enjoy them. We'll dive right in. What you see in front of you is the Hidden World playset. There are different ones. The Hidden World playset comes in a box, like this, and you can see that there is the Light Fury inside the little cave structure. There are three different ones so far. One is with Toothless, one is with a Light Fury, and one is with Hookfang, which is the kind of... orange dragon with two googly eyes on top of his head. They do have a product number. You can see there's the barcode, and then there's two lines of text. And this top number, 201-038-608, is a similar format to what's on the other products. You'll see on the Mystery Dragons packaging, here on the bottom, there's the barcode and two lines of numbers. And this one has 201-03-495. They all seem to start with 201-03, and then the last three digits are different. On the How to Train Your Dragon Hidden World Mystery Dragon blind bags, you can see on the back here we have the barcode, and then we have two other lines of numbers, and they have the 20103. Now these are, this one says 847, but the numbers range, so far that I can tell, from 37 all the way up to 52. I don't have them all, but I do have a duplicate of 47, so we're going to open the 47s first and see if they are the same dragon. If they are the same dragon, then we can conclude that these last two digits indicate which dragon is in the package. And of course, something else I picked up, you know how I like little baby animals in eggs. They have dragon eggs with the How to Train Your Dragon logo, and inside is a plush dragon. And on the back, they have 201-03-549. The numbers are 49, 50. I don't have 51, 52, 53, and 54. I feel like I bought six of these because I wanted to have a complete set. And yet I've looked around the entire house, and I bought them so long ago, there may be one in a bag by itself somewhere, either in the car or in my office lost or somewhere else. I'm not sure. But if I find it, I'll let you know. We're going to open these five that we have today. Because I'm in a different location today, you probably have noticed by now. My setup's a little bit different, and the office manager has stopped by to check on things, to see how we're doing. Hi, Pumpkin. Alright, one other thing I wanted to note about these is that the How to Train Your Dragon toys are made by Spinmaster, and you know I loves me some Spinmaster. So let's open up number 49 in the eggs and see what we've got. You can see it's a nice plastic egg. It's Toothless! Now you can actually, for the most part, you can see through the egg and tell who you're going to get. And of course the black egg has Toothless in it. But isn't he adorable? I just love this little plushy guy. It's got quite a big tag, but the quality is quite good. He doesn't have any weird seams or anything. He's very plushy and very soft, and he has little felt ears and spikes and wings. This must be Toothless before his injury because he doesn't have his prosthetic tail. He has a regular natural tail. But anyway, super adorable. We're going to open dragon number 50. Do have a perforation along the plastic if you can find it. Dragon number 50 is kind of in a purple egg, and you can see that it is the blue dragon. I don't know all of their names off the top of my head, but I bet you do, and you can tell me who this is. Hopefully there's a guide inside the blind bag dragons that will tell us all the characters' names, because they didn't include it in the eggs. Skipping 51 and going straight to 52, we have a slightly orange egg. And this little guy, now you can tell when you get them out of the, oh, he has real wings. And this one does too. They're not felt. They're plushy. Toothless's wings are felt. But these have actually been, it's just layers of fabric sewn together, so that's neat. So that's 52. 53 is a yellow egg. And it is the green dragon that looks like the other one. Again, with the sewn wings. Super adorable. 54 is a blue egg with sort of round bits on it. And it's this guy with the two little adorable tiny, tiny flaps on top of his head. I love this guy. So cute. $49.50. Skipping 51, 52, 53, and 54. I don't know if there's going to be more of these in the future, but that's what we have right now. I will try to pick up number 51 at some point if I don't find it in the house here. Back to the Hidden World playset. The cool thing about this is that it has a black light in it, and the dragons are supposed to glow under black light when you put them inside this cave and push the button. Let's open up the box and take a closer look at the Light Fury. As with most Spinmaster toys, inside the box you have a set of instructions. It explains that it does run on batteries, so you can replace the LR44s in it and it will work again after it stops working. We do have the customer service card. It's bright yellow and very easy to read. And the playset. So the playset is just a little plastic cave. It's really, really pretty, actually. I'm assuming this looks like the Hidden World does in the movie. At least it's got some elements. It's got the crystals and the green foliage and the crystalline rocks all the way around. And then, of course, we have our Light Fury. Now, unfortunately, because she's been in a plastic package, she's got blue marks on her face. I don't know if that's from the heat or from friction, but that doesn't seem to want to come off. So, unfortunately, our Light Fury does have a paint defect. As far as figures go, it's quite simple. It's made out of a soft, rubbery plastic, so you won't necessarily hurt your foot all that bad if you step on it. But it doesn't have any moving parts. The head doesn't move, the legs don't move, the arms don't move, the wings don't move. Although they will sort of flap a little bit if you squeeze them, so you can do that during play. As I said, the coolest thing about the little mini dragons is you put them in the cave, and you push the button, and they glow under black light. The Light Fury has a black light reactive paint on the back of its wings. And now we're going to move on to the Mystery Dragon 2-pack. You can see that one dragon is already revealed, and that is Toothless. And then we have another dragon that is in a cardboard box with a giant question mark. Again, the number on the bottom of this one is 495. It does say on the package, and hopefully you can see, that there are what it says are rare bioluminescent dragons that will react to the black light in the hidden cave. So, you can see here that this Toothless has marks on its back and its head and its wings, and it does in fact glow in black light. Here's Toothless in regular light. Well, I assume it's Toothless. It could be a different Night Fury, to be honest. But you can see the pattern is clearly visible without the black light. And again, this is a soft, rubbery plastic. It does have an awful lot of segments. The head is attached separately. The torso is separate. This wing segment is separate. And the tail segment is a segment all by itself. I assume that has something to do with the molding process. But it's a shame they don't have any moving parts like our friends do in the Mattel line for the mini-action dinos. And let's see who we have inside the box. Pretty rad. Once again, segments where there could be movement but isn't. The sculpt and detail is really nice, though, and the paint's nice, and the teeth are all detailed pretty well, and it's just, it's a shame that they don't include a list or character names or anything in any of these dragons. I guess you're supposed to play the How to Train Your Dragon phone game and have all the names memorized. I don't, but I do like the dragons. They look very cool. Of the How to Train Your Dragon Hidden World Mystery Dragon packs, I have 37 through 44. Then I have two of number 47 to check and make sure that it's the same dragon. And I also have number 52. So I've got quite a few to catch up if indeed each number is a different dragon. Let's open the two 47s and take a look. The first 47 is Toothless. And the second 47 is Toothless again. That's kind of lucky, because I'm going to have to figure out what to do with these extras. And since it's a duplicate, I won't have any qualms about giving it away to someone who wants it. So, since 47 is Toothless, we can be pretty sure that the rest of these, each number is going to be a different dragon. Let me get them open, and we'll go over who we got. Oh, and once again, super sad face, there's no guide in any of the packaging to say how many dragons there are, what their names are, or what we should be looking for in these other packages. So I have no idea who's in there. We're just going to open it and see what we've got. This is a bit of a hot mess, and I did go and look up the dragons' names that are here. It was difficult. Each dragon has a name, if they're a character that's named, but there's also the kind of dragon they are. 37 is an angry night fury. You can see his teeth showing. We presume this is Toothless. It is different than 47 that we opened. You can see here, 47 is curved tail one way, no teeth. This one is curved tail the other way, and teeth. So 47 and 37 are different versions of Toothless. 38 is, I think, Stormfly, and I think that it is a deadly Nadder. Again, we're assuming this is supposed to be that character. Looks somewhat like it. They do have more detail in the artwork that I've seen, but this one is just plain blue with yellow and a little bit of coloring on the wings. Now, I will say this. These are all soft, rubbery figures, and the painting and the detail work is quite good for such a small little dragon, so I'm pleased with them, even though if I don't know them all quite well enough, they're great dragons. Alright, so this is presumably Hookfang, and Hookfang is a nightmare. This is number 39. We can also assume that this plush is supposed to be Hookfang. Which, does that make this one Fanghook? I'm not sure. You'll have to let me know. I couldn't find any conclusive answer to that one. This is the Gronkle Meatlug. And that is number 40. 41, we have, I think, a Zippleback. And this might be Barf and Belch, but I'm not sure. 41. 42 is most definitely Skullcrusher, and that is a Rumblehorn. Very distinct looking dragon. I've only seen one of these in the story, so I'm pretty sure that's who this is. And that's also the same dragon that was in the box in the two-pack. 43, we got another Light Fury. This one does not have bioluminescence, but anyway, we have another Light Fury here, and that was number 43. 44 is Cloud Jumper, and that is a Stormcutter dragon, according to what I looked up. Double wings there, very nice detail, very nice coloring. Cool dragon, I like this one. All right, so 47 is our regular Toothless, and 52, for some reason, is a silver Night Fury, presumably Toothless, so it's a silver version of Toothless. That means we're missing 45 and 46, and also 48, 49, 50, and 51. So I'm going to see if I can find those numbers at the store, and then we'll know who they are. But I'm also going to post this list in the description of the video, so you can reference it when you're shopping, and at least you'll know these that we already have opened. Taking a closer look at the dragons, I just wanted to double check the bioluminescence thing. You can see that this Toothless does have bioluminescence stripes on his back. Now this is one of the number 47s that we opened, and I can tell that he's bioluminescent because you can see he has these clear stripes on his back, Those are UV reactive, so when the black light hits it, they light up. So you can look at the other dragons, and if they have these kind of markings that look like clear nail polish almost painted on, then they will glow under the black light. Hopefully you can see in there. This is Cloud Jumper that we got from the blind bags. And you can see that there are, in fact, glow-in-the-dark marks on his back. This is one of the Skullcrushers that we've got. And he does have the striping. I have a feeling that's the one that was out of the box, not the bag. And just to show you, the blind bag Light Fury doesn't have any specific markings that glow in the dark, but because she's white, sort of all of the plastic is reactive. The one that actually came with the playset has specific markings. And other than the various versions of Toothless that I have, those are the only bioluminescent dragons that I have. So there is our look at the How to Train Your Dragon Hidden World merchandise from Spinmaster. There will be duplicates between the boxed sets of dragons and the miniature bags, but within the different sets, especially the mini bags, be sure to look at these numbers by the barcode, because the numbers will tell you which dragon you are getting. If you buy a different number every time, you are almost guaranteed to not get a duplicate. I say almost guaranteed because they could mislabel or mispackage one, and you know, accidents happen. But you should get different dragons if you do that. Of all of them, I would say my favorite are definitely the plushies. I just have a soft spot for soft little plushy dragons. But the miniatures are extremely cool, and I hope that they come up with more playsets that you can use with the miniatures, because right now there's only the three little caves, and there's a lot of opportunities there for expansion of the line. Hope you've enjoyed the video, dragon fans. If you have, don't forget to press the like button, share and subscribe, and hit the bell icon to be notified when I upload a new video. You know the drill. And until next time, enjoy the movie. Hi, Pumpkin. You like hanging out on the table? You're such a good baby. Kala's next to me asleep in the chair, but Pumpkin likes to be right up in the action. Don't ya? You gonna play with the plastic? Well, don't eat it. Can't taste very good. Ooh, she's feisty. Don't bite. Mama's little angel over here with all teeth and claws. She's gonna murder me. She's going to murder me one day. Aren't ya? You can see it in her eyes. Okay. Say bye-bye, Pumpkin.